test review 2, number 9. Here we have a linear equation that we want to solve for x. It has parentheses, so the first step is going to be to distribute in clear parentheses. So we distribute the 6, we get 6x plus 6 equals 6x plus 48. Now our next step would be to collect like terms on each side separately, but neither side has like terms to collect. So we're going to go to the next step in solving a linear system, or a linear equation, which is get all the x's on one side. So let's subtract 6x from this side to move x's left. That one cancels, and we're left with something a bit strange. Normally we'd be left with an x on the left side or somewhere, and we'd want to move numbers to the other side, but now we're left with a statement that 6 equals 48. Whenever you get just a statement with numbers in it and your x's disappear, you need to decide what the statement is telling you. If statement is false, then your conclusion will be there is no solution. The way I like to look at that is that 6 equals 48 will always be false, no matter what I put in for x. And no matter what value I put in for x, it's going to cancel out here. And I'll always get 6 equals 48. And since we're trying to find the value of x that makes a statement true, it's never going to happen. 6 will never equal 48. So that means there is no solution for x. No solution is our conclusion. So there's our answer. If, on the other hand, our statement had been true, which you might encounter in some problems, then what you want to conclude is that all real numbers will work. And for example, let's say we ended up with 6 equals 6 as a statement. Well, 6 will always equal 6. No matter what we put in for the equation that came above it and led to 6 equals 6, the x's will cancel out. Any x value will cancel out. And we'll always get 6 equals 6, which is true. So all real numbers would be the solution in that case. But for the problem we're working on, no solution as our final answer.